Assalamu alaikum, welcome to the Islamic Beliefs. The cosmological argument for the existence of God. One of the key arguments which is normally used to advance the belief in the existence of God is known as the cosmological argument. This argument has traditionally been advanced within monotheistic circles, but as its name indicates, the argument is primarily one which developed among the Arabic Muslim scholastic environment. The argument has been praised by many philosophers and theologians for several reasons. One of these reasons is that the argument necessitates God. However, unlike other arguments from a philosophical framework, it does not necessitate a specific philosophical or limited God, but rather merely God itself. For this reason, the argument has become popular in more than just Muslim circles, despite the fact that the argument itself is originally one that flourished and was produced among its Muslim groups. The argument goes as follows. Number one, whatever begins to exist must have a cause. That is to say, something which was not eternally existing, or something which did not exist forever in the past, namely something which begins to exist, must have something which caused it. Number two, the universe began to exist. That is to say that according to all specialists regarding the organs of the universe, we have a clear cut and good reasons to believe that there was a point in time in which the universe did not exist. That is a subject that latest cutting-edge research in contemporary cosmology and is especially known as the Big Bang model. The Big Bang model replaced the previous mistaken steady-state theory, which held that the universe was eternal. This change in the scientific community was at first met by the opposition from atheist scientists who argue that the new Big Bang theory was merely atheists' way to bring God back into scientific discourse. Number three, since the universe came into existence and began to exist, it therefore must have a cause. The choices for the universe's causes are numerous. Here we shall analyze them. Number one, the universe brought itself into existence. This is impossibility and is akin to believing in the superstitious magic, namely that something can create itself from nothing. Therefore, it is extremely rejected by reason. Number two, the universe was produced by multiverse of numerous universes. This is by denying the explanation of the creator, and we would ask who created the multiverse. Number three, the universe was created by a creator who himself is necessarily existent and did not emerge in time but existed infinitely. This seems to be the only plausible conclusion which can be derived from the dilemma of this first argument. In summary, we have argued that rationally everything which begins to exist must have a cause. The universe began to exist, therefore the universe has a cause. The cause of the universe must also be an infinitely uncaused being. This uncaused being is known as God. In order to disprove such an argument, the burden of proof is upon those who deny the claim to bring evidence that there is such a thing as a thing which begins to exist without a cause. If they try to respond by saying that Muslims believe God exists and that he did not have a creator, they are merely demonstrating their ignorance, because according to all Muslims, God did not begin exist, rather he has existed eternally. If they wish to argue that the universe existed eternally, then they have to demonstrate that the latest scientific research is to be rejected, and they should convince the scientific community that their findings are wrong. Thank you very much for watching. Fi amanillah.